Hello, welcome to Michelle Sews Again. I'm Michelle. It is another installment of my collabathon for Sew Purple to End ALZ. And today I am with the incomparable Jen from Today in Jen's Sewing Room. If you want to see what we've made, then please stay tuned. Okay, so I know that you're all aware of Jen because she's the mother of Friday Sews, which we all love to watch. And I feel very lucky to be able to actually call her a friend in real life, which is, it's the best. She is so much fun. She's such a good person. She's got a good heart, and she loves to teach, and she brings the sewing community together with that Friday Sews hashtag. And in every one of her videos, she's all about the sewing community and making it better. And that's what I love so much about her. So what do you think that we decided to make? You won't be surprised to find out that we are making the Simplicity 8640, which you already know is Jen's absolute favorite pattern. She has done a full review on this pattern. I will link it in the description box below. I'm gonna kind of hit some highlights and things that I found for me personally. It's not gonna be a full-fledged review. I'll just refer you to Jen's video for that. She has made several of these dresses. I don't know if it's 5 or 6 or 7. She's made at least one in knit, even though the pattern calls for lightweight woven fabrics. So yeah, go and check out all of her versions of the 8640. I decided that this would be a good one for us to make because it comes in, it is now available all the way up to size 28W, which goes up to a bust size of 50. Surprisingly, on the pattern packet, there's actually finished garment measurements. The big four never do that. So, you'll know I don't make a lot of big four patterns because they don't typically go up to my size. In fact, I believe the majority, whenever I look at one, whenever somebody makes something that I'm like, God, I wish that was available for me. And I go and look and it's in a 26W and the bust size is 48 inches. And I don't have the patience or the desire to add the extra several inches that would be required for it to fit me. So I don't even bother. And because the big four don't typically put, finished measurements on their, packets, there's no way for me to know how much ease, if there's enough ease in that 48 inch bust for it to actually fit me. This pattern actually goes up to a 28, which is a 50 bust. And I'm right now between a 50 and a 51. And I have heard that the big four have a pretty generous amount of ease, so I decided to go ahead and take the plunge and to give this a shot. Surprisingly though, this pattern does have the finished garment measurements on the packet, which is unusual. So for the size 28, the finished bust measurement is 55 inches. It doesn't give you the finished waist or hip measurements, and I can tell you that from the packet for the size 28, it says the bust size is 50, the waist is 44, and the hip is 52. All of those measurements are just under my measurements. I'm like 50, 51 for the bust, 46 for the waist, and 53 for the hip. So 1 to 2 inches more in my body than what the pattern says should fit. But like I said, big four are known to have ease, so I decided to give it a shot. I decided to make view C. I really wanted sleeves on this. I think most of Jen's are made sleeveless, but I decided to make the one with the sleeve, which is also the shorter length version of the dress. So it's funny because it calls view A a dress and it calls view B and C a tunic, even though the tunic hits at the knees. To me, that's a dress, but that's okay. All right. So now I'm going to go ahead and show you the twirl of me wearing this dress, and then I'll talk you through some of the changes that I made. So as you can see here, I've styled it with a nice filigree silver necklace. I felt like this needed something a little chunkier. I wear a lot of delicate kind of daintier necklaces. I used to wear a lot of big oversized jewelry, but I don't really have the occasion to wear that often anymore, but I thought that this dress needed that. So, and I still have quite a few of these big necklaces in my collection. So I thought that would be nice. And then I paired it with these diamond hoop earrings. So I thought that was a good, keeping it in the cool color family, the silver with the purples. I thought that looked good. And I ended up wearing these brown leather wedges. I know they have gold detail, but I actually enjoy mixing metals, so that didn't bother me at all. And these are seriously some of the most comfortable wedges that I own. They just fit my foot snug without being tight, so they keep me in place. And although this is wood, I mean, it's actually really comfortable. I love those shoes. So that's how I decided to style it, and I'm really happy with that. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that at the end. So overall, I believe I made the right size. I know that a lot of people, like, I'm just now noticing that, like, the shoulder comes down past the edge of my shoulder. That is not a fit issue that I ever worry about. I know that, you know, if you're doing proper fitting, that is a thing, but I couldn't care less. I think it's because I grew up with ready-to-wear never fitting me there, and I just never even thought twice about it. In fact, if I hadn't watched other YouTubers talk about it, I wouldn't even know that that was a thing. And so I couldn't care less about that. It doesn't bother me. However, from a fit perspective, you'll see in the video, I'll drop it up here again. I think that overall, I made the right size. It fits in the bust. There is some ease, which is the right amount of ease for me. I don't like it too tight right there. There's the waist of it actually hits me higher than where my smallest part of my waist is, which is going to continue to be a theme here, I think. But it still doesn't, I would nip it in just a little bit more just to give it some shape. Because right now I feel like it kind of looks like a little, much like a gunny sack. But that's the only really thing, from that perspective. I would just nip in just a little bit on the sides, not much at all. And then I would also do a full bicep adjustment. Although when I'm just holding my arms out like this, it doesn't look like it's tight, but when I move my arms, it's definitely a little tight. So I would do the full bicep adjustment as well. Those are the only two fit things that I think that I would change. Other than that, I'm pretty happy with the way that it fits. The fabrics that I used are, I used three different cotton lawns that I got from Joann's. Originally, I was going to do this in a mix of gingham fabrics. I was going to do it in these three fabrics. And these are actually pretty nice. That gingham that I used for the apron the other day, I can definitely tell that that's a polyester gingham. These are a cotton gingham. They feel much nicer than that one. And I think they would have made a nice dress. I think I was just worried about how the plaids would work. The pattern actually says not to use plaids. It's not suitable for plaids. So that kind of made me a little bit nervous. I did use this watercolor stripe, and I do regret that I didn't take the time to match up the stripes together. But it is what it is at this point. All right, so I have a few of these scraps left, so I'll show you these. So this is the watercolor stripe, and I really like this. These cotton lawns are nice, lightweight cotton fabrics. They have a little bit of drape, not a lot, but they're not super stiff either. So I have, and these are all kind of coordinated. So I've got this one with the purples, many different shades of purple and lilac and gray and white. And then this one that kind of looks like water droplets or paint, not really paint splatters. I would call them more water droplets. And then this one is more like a paint splatter. So those are the three fabrics that I mixed together. So in the video, you'll see that I kind of cut the watercolor stripes so that they go this way. This pattern piece is actually designed to be cut on the bias. For the size that I made and the width of fabric that I had, I was not able to put it on an exact 45 degree angle. It went further than the edges of the fabric. So I shifted it a little bit. I don't know what angle it was, but it's not a true bias. I guess maybe it is. Bias just means off grain, right? it's not a 45 degree bias. And I think it still worked fine. It would have worked better, obviously, if I had lined up the stripes, but it worked fine. It's not shifting out of shape or anything like that. The back piece, I had to piece together two different fabrics because this fabric was not long enough for the full pattern piece. So I just cut it in a spot where I thought would make sense, and I added a half an inch seam allowance to both pieces so that I could do that seam and not lose any of the length, so that all my pieces would, my side seams would all still match up. I did shorten the sleeve by 1 inch. I moved the pockets way up. When I put the pockets where the markings are on the pattern pieces, and they were literally like almost down by my knees. I didn't know if that's because I have little T-Rex arms, but Jen said that she always has to move the pockets up as well. So that made me feel a little bit better. That those are just drafted in a weird place. And I switched out the neck facing for bias binding. I'm just not a fan of facings if I can help it. I found that the construction of this dress was really easy. Once I put together the front pieces and the back pieces, I actually didn't even bother following the instructions anymore, because at that point, it was just sewing side seams, shoulder seams, putting in sleeves, and hemming it. I did look at the instructions just to double check how to address that hem. So there's like a little notch out of the side of the hem. I don't know if you can see that on there. And really it's super easy. All you do is a baby hem around that curve and then a baby hem along the bottom. And you just connect those. So that was actually really easy. There was nothing about this that was difficult. The pocket was really interesting construction. So there's the outer pocket that has gathers at the bottom, and then there's an inner pocket that lines it, that kind of brings it all together. And, I just think that detail is kind of neat looking. So I actually might save these pockets and use them for other things because I think they're pretty. So I'll be honest, when I tried this on after I sewed it, or as I was sewing it, like before I put the sleeves on and everything, I was not feeling it. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm spending so much time on this. And I actually, like, I had put these top pieces on backwards. So I put this piece on this bottom and this piece on this bottom. I stitched them and serged them until I realized that they were on the wrong piece and I had to unpick all that. And so I put a lot of effort into this. Now, some of it was my fault, but I was like, after all that effort, I don't like the way it looks on me. I put the sleeves in, I moved the pockets, and after I finished everything, I put it on and I looked in the mirror and I was like, oh my God, I look so dumpy. But that was me, like, no undergarments, my hair wasn't fixed, my face wasn't fixed, I didn't accessorize, I was barefoot, and it looked dumpy. I was like, okay, well, I've got to jazz this up for my twirl. And so I thought about what accessories to wear, what shoes to wear. I put a little bit of makeup on. I don't know if you guys can tell, I've been having fun with my makeup this month. I pulled out all of my purple eyeshadow palettes, which sounds kind of crazy that I say all. Most people, if they even have a purple eyeshadow palette, they probably have one. I have very many. I was addicted to beauty YouTube channels before I started sewing, and I watched those for years. In fact, at one point, I probably had as much makeup as a lot of these like beauty gurus had, and I decluttered probably 75% of it before I moved from Philadelphia. But I still have quite, the eyeshadow palettes were my favorite. So I've been having fun with that this month, my purple. Anyway, so I jazzed myself up, and when I was doing my video and I was editing my little twirl, I was like, oh, I look kind of cute. Okay. So I'm feeling better about it. So like I said, I'll just make those couple of tweaks with the bicep and then the side seams. And I think I'll have a nice dress if I ever need something to make for like a nicer event. I don't like this on me if I'm not wearing heels. I will tell you that. And I don't wear heels a lot. So to me, this would be something, I know Jen is able to like wear it with like flats or flip flops or sneakers, but that's because she's tall and slim and it looks great on her. I'm short and squatty and that just looks dumpy on me. So when I have heels on, I like it, but I only wear heels when I have like an event to go to. So it's gonna be more of a special occasion pattern for me. And I'll, you know, if I make it again, it'll be in a, you know, I don't know, maybe a nicer fabric. I don't know. I never have events to go to, but if I did, this could be a contender. This is a great pattern. If you like to do color blocking, if you like to do pattern mixing, you can do all of that with this. And I think it looks really nice. Please check out Jen's channel to see her newest version of the 8640. I can't wait to see what she did. I believe she's made a dress for her daughter who is pregnant, but I'm not 100% positive. If you missed yesterday's video, then go and check that out. It was with Trish from Pinky's Farm, and we made a hair dry towel, a DIY hair towel wrap, whatever you want to call it. That was a lot of fun. And stay tuned for tomorrow's video, which is with the amazing Mari from Mari Sews, and we're collaborating on Project Dress a Girl. So it'll be my second Project Dress a Girl dress for the month, and it's with the queen of Project Dress a Girl herself, Mari. So be sure to check that out tomorrow. As usual, I will have all of the ALZ info in the description box. I'll have a link to my intro video. If you don't know what So Purple to End ALZ is all about, then go check out that intro video. I talk about all the collaborations. I give you a little bit of story about my dad, who this is all in his memory. I talk about the donation page that's also in a tribute page for my father, and all of the collaborators, the projects that we're working on, and the dates that those are going up on YouTube are all in the description box below. And wherever you are, I hope the weather's amazing. I hope you're able to get some sewing in, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.